Hey you guys, this is Yakanshi and welcome back to the new video of Heart to Heart. And I mean, if you guys remember, a few days back I posted a Q&A on my story, on my Instagram story, that you guys, if you guys have any questions regarding fashion or fashion design as a field, as a career option, or if you want to know anything about it, so you can DM me or drop your questions over there. So first of all, I want to thank you guys that you guys were so supportive and you all have like sent me so many questions. I got so many DMs because as you guys know that I belong to a fashion field and I am from a fashion design background. Basically, I have like completed my graduation from United World Institute of Design in Ahmedabad, if you guys don't know. Yeah, so first of all, yeah, and if you guys find me sitting down here a lot, that is because I have my laptop right here and I have all the information saved over here that I'm gonna tell. So as I got so many questions, I thought that I should segregate things in the parts, and so today basically in this episode we're gonna talk about how to apply for, because a lot of guys asked me that you're from UID and how to apply basically for UID. So I thought that I should start with this, and how the application process goes, and what kind of exams you have to go through, what are the eligibility areas and everything. So that all I'm gonna cover in today's topic. So let's get started. Alright, so we'll start with the eligibility criteria, okay? So in case you are applying to undergraduate program of any of the department, like any of the design field in UID, so what you need to do is you have to have cleared your 10 plus 2, that is 12th, and you must be having proper documents of all of that, as well as you have to score, like you should have scored at least 50% of marks in your 10 plus 2, okay? That is the eligibility criteria for undergraduate. And when it comes to post-graduation, so for that, you must have cleared your 10 plus 2, that is of course there, as well as 50% of marks. And you can be from any field, whether it's science or arts, commerce, any background is fine. And apart from that, for post-graduation, you should have cleared your bachelor's degree as well, okay? So that are the two highlights which you need to keep in mind while applying for undergrad or post-grad. And there are no age limit bars, like there are no upper age limit bars or lower age limit bars that you cannot apply after this or before that. So that's like a plus point, that whether you're of any age, whether you have completed your studies in some different department and you want to switch your career, you're planning to like, you know, try something new or learn something new, or suddenly like maybe you have realized that you have interest in something else, so you can do that as well. So like, yeah, so that's basically the good part about UID, because in a lot of other institutes what happens that they have set the age bars, okay, that you cannot apply for this exam after this age, but in UID there's nothing like that, so you don't have to worry about it, that you cannot do designing if you have pursued medical or engineering or anything. So yeah. Now we'll talk about the application process, okay, because that is the first step to apply to any of the design college. And so yeah, basically for the application process what happens, that first of all you have to give an exam of DAT, that is Design Aptitude Test. So for that, when you have to register, your application forms will always be coming on Karnavati's site, website, and I'm gonna mention the website down in the description box, so you don't have to worry about it, you can just click it and you can go to that website and read about it, of course. So yeah, so first of all you have to apply on that, and the application forms comes around mid of the October, and till the mid of the January the forms are there, like you can apply till mid of the January. So that how it goes, the application process. And yeah, and once you are done with your application process, the admit card that you receive, so basically February midweek that you get, that is you get that exactly 1 week before the exam dates, okay? And it is really important to have your admit card while you are going for the exam, because that is the thing which you need to have while entering for the exam, okay? Then comes the registration fees. So while registering yourself for the admit card or for the exam, you need to pay a certain amount, and that is the registration fees. So that is 2000 rupees, and that is for all the people, and that is for undergrad as well as postgrad. So 2000 is the amount for that, and then comes the payment mode. So you can pay by debit card, credit card, by any of the online modes, as well as you can also pay through the demand draft if you don't want to pay online. So yeah, and you can read all the details about demand drafts, offline things, and how you have to do it on the link mentioned below in the description. Now comes that how exactly the process happens, okay? So for that, first up, the step one is that you have to go to the Karnavati's official website, that is karnavatiuniversity.edu.in/UID. That also I'm gonna mention below, so don't bother to write it up by pausing the video, don't worry about that. And then there you'll get a link which says apply online, so you have to follow that link. And for this step two, you have to register yourself by entering a valid email ID and your contact number. Then you will receive all the credentials, all the login credentials on your email ID as well as your contact number. Now step three is that with the credentials that you'll get on your information, you have to apply through that. And you have to download the application form with the help of those credentials. And then the most important process, after downloading the form, you have to take a printout of that form, and then you have to fill all the details about yourself, which whatever is asked, and make sure that you are answering everything correctly, like especially the documents they have asked. And you have to make sure that you are not typing it out, you have to write it down in your own handwriting. To completely fill your application form, then what you have to do, you have to take that form and along with the documents, and then you have to send everything, like you have to post everything on the address, on the given address, okay? So now as you are eligible to give the exam, now comes what is the exam pattern basically, okay? So for the first exam, that is design aptitude test. It's an offline exam which is conducted with the help of pen and paper, of course. You will be getting a lot of MCQs to answer. The time that will be given for the exam is exactly 3 hours. So you'll get basically 3 hours to fill up the MCQs, to answer, basically to do the whole exam. The language will be English, and so you have to answer everything in that. And apart from that, the marking scheme. So basically 1 mark is awarded for every right answer. And the good part is that there is no negative marking for any of the wrong answers. Then the exactly pattern for undergrad that comes in the design aptitude test is general IQ test, critical analysis test, critical ability test, creative analysis test. So there will be questions and the exercises. So basically it will be in this pattern to judge you whether you have all of these capabilities or not, because these are the few things which are really important to become a designer. Then for the pattern of post-graduation, it is critical analysis test, critical ability test, and creative analysis test. So now you know that why I have my laptop, because I have typed down everything here, because I don't want to go wrong with any of the words, because I want to give the exact information to you guys so that it will be like really easy for you guys to appear for the exams. Okay, so basically then we come to exam centers. So UID exam centers when it happens, a design aptitude test. So for that overall there are 23 design centers across the India for UID exams specifically. So I'll just quickly tell you guys that what all are the exam centers usually they keep. So the cities that are there are Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Bhopal, Bhubaneswar, Chandigarh, Chennai, Dehradun, New Delhi, Guwahati, Hyderabad, Indore, and Mumbai. Then comes the results. So results, what happens that they basically declare the results on the official website of United World Institute of Design for both the UG as well as PG, that is undergraduate or postgraduate. Done with your first part, that is design ability test. if you have cleared that exam, they will automatically upload all the cleared students' names on their official website. So you have to keep a track and you have to check that. Anyways, you will be getting a mail from their side, but just in case, to be sure. And once you clear that first step, then comes the next exams. So then comes the situation test as well as your portfolio evaluation. Okay, those are the two final steps. So basically these two exams happens in the campus of United World Institute of Design, which is in Gandhinagar, Gujarat, Ahmedabad. Yeah, so that generally happens in the month of April, and it is mandatory for all the qualified students to attend the situation test and portfolio evaluation, because otherwise you will not be eligible to enter the college, because you have to go through all of these three process, and you need to clear all of these three things, otherwise you are not allowed to enter the college. Okay, so final shortlisted students, like the ones who have cleared all the three stages, results appear in the month of May based on the marks obtained, and that also they're gonna upload everything on the website. Basically, how the situation test happens, right? You might be thinking that what is situation test, right? So situation test is very simple. Like, you know, what you have to do is basically in situation test there will be task which is given to you. It will be a creative and design based task, and you'll get all the exercises, questions which is majorly of the creative side, and the task, and you will be in few of the questions, you will be given few of the things, and you have to design something out of it, or you have to create something out of it, and and some questions will be related to sketching, some questions will be related to painting. So there will be a lot of these kind of things, and I'll be making a whole different episode, don't worry about it, that what all comes in situation test and how you can clear it, what all you need to study or prepare for that. So don't worry about that. And then for the personal evaluation, of course, portfolio evaluation, of course, there you need to have your portfolio, design portfolio, which is an accessory of a designer, basically. So yeah, you need to carry that, and you will be evaluated, you will be asked questions about that, and so basically that's it. Yeah, and then we'll talk about what are the courses that are offered in undergrad. So for undergrad, you already have Bachelor's of Design in Product Design, Fashion Design, Automobile and Transportation Design, Interaction Design, Visual Communications, Animations and Motion Graphics, Lifestyle and Accessory Designs, Interior Design and Furniture Design, Photography. So basically there are a lot of different options for undergraduate courses as designers and creative fields, and they are still, as far as I know, that basically these were the things when I was there in college, it was all of these courses that they were offering, and I opted for fashion design, and as far as I know, they are currently working on some new courses, and they're also coming up with some new courses in a year or two. So definitely keep checking on their website for sure. And then comes the post-graduation courses. For post-graduation courses, they offer design and industrial design, visual design, fashion styling and communication, fashion design, textile and knitwear design, interior and experience designs. Then they also have PhD courses. They offer PhD in fashion design, product design, interior design, visual communication. So these are the courses that they offer. And now I feel that I have given you almost all the information about how the application process goes, how you have to apply for it, and what all exactly are the stages that you go through. So these are basically a few important points that you need to take care of while you are appearing for any of the design exam, like whether it's related to any college. Mostly all the colleges have same process, it's just few of the process are there which are different, few of the things are different. Apart from that, all the design colleges have almost same process of how students go through these stages, and then what are the marking points, and then what kind of questions, what kind of paper, exam pattern. So almost everything is pretty same in all the design colleges. So yeah, so this was about so basically this information is majorly related to United World Institute of Design, which is in Ahmedabad, Gandhinagar, and yeah, and it is basically a private university, as a lot of you guys asked me on DM that whether it's private or government. So it's a private university, and yeah, so that's it for like today's information. And if you guys still have any questions about the application process and how to apply or register yourself for the exam patterns, you guys can always comment down below, and make sure that you're commenting down that if you have any other queries of related anything to fashion design. And so definitely I'm gonna keep making more different videos and different episodes for this, so that I'll give you all the information which is related to fashion design, so that you don't have to worry about it. So yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope it was useful information for you guys, and thank you so much for watching and staying till here. Lots of love. Bye.